clutch. How these words get touched unless your boss giving us brain.
Nigga, you ain't serving us.
He getting it all.
Learning language but studying English.
Our true lives break more punks than
Harry Rehnquist.
Harry Rehnquist.
We the best speech. Roll with keys and smoke more trees than a slash and burn technique.
Sex beats between bed sheets.
Red fleets, pork fiction style.
Leaving your car in red seats.
We make life fly swatters and smash pests.
Put pizza number richer than the Kelly Price Benson.
Anybody's looking like samples with the Rorschach test.
Ink blots.
So fuck around, get your
team rock.
Jugs in the back with the beam cock. The plots to have everything
between LA and Queens Lot.
Queens
Lot.
Queens
Lot.
Queens
Lot. Queens
Lot.
Queens Lot. Queens Lot.
We're here with Cunnilingus. They just did a show. Natty, Deke, No, DJ, Flip Flop, Flip Flop. That's right from Portland. You guys just did a show. How did it feel, man, being here back in Austin?
It was great. I'm blessed, tired, sweating, cold. Might have H1N1.
Might have it. It's coming around.
I mean, it felt good. Every time I come to Austin, Austin is like the coolest city in Texas. There's ATMs on every corner.
Every corner.
You ever find yourself needing to buy anything, they got you.
Absolutely get robbed.
All the time.
All the time.
All the time.
All the time.
How do you feel about Austin?
I feel great. The green room is a little draggy. Because there's a hole that's outside right here. So, but yeah, man, I like Austin, and I think we've had a good time every time we come out here. We've been out here to South by Southwest, obviously, every day, at least once.
Right.
Just the experience. But yeah, just in general, it's kind of a little, it's like, you know what I'm saying? It's like a little West Coast town, like in the middle of Texas. So
right,
really
right.
I like it, you know what I'm saying? I say that? That's a bad
say whatever you want, man.
I fuck with it heavy. I love this fucking place, goddamn.
We fuck with each other.
We fuck with each other. I appreciate it. You guys just recently came out with an album. Tell me, you gotta let us know, you know, what went into making that? What's that album like?
Art.
New album.
Pardon?
It's actually not an album, it's a mixtape. We just approach it like an album. It's all new material. We don't jack for beats. We don't rap over Soulja Boy tracks. You know what I'm saying? We don't do all that mixtape, general mixtape stuff.
Right.
But it's all new. It's all new music. There's some guest spots. And we dropped two in a year. Who does that?
Right.
Really? Who does that? So, you know what I'm saying? We treat it like, we treat it like an album, even though it's a mixtape, and it's all original material, so, you know what I'm saying?
Deep.
The villain?
The villain actually mobilized all those songs, all the throwaway songs that we had, sitting on the cutting room. You know, we use a mixtape just to show a looser side of ourselves, but we're still artists, so we always want the project, we always want to close to our community. Because nowadays, everybody, every mama, everybody, grandma has a mixtape. So it's like, you can't just throw something out there and just thank people and then just consume it. You know, they chew the shit up. By dinner, they're ready for the next mixtape, you know. So, yeah. Pardon.
I just want to rap and shit. They tell me there's shit to rap on and I come rap.
So, shit. Rap.
But I enjoy doing what we do, you know what I'm saying? I like the music because I feel like really it's a mixtape, quote unquote. Even though say it 20 times, the fans are still not going to treat it like a mixtape. I don't blame them because we put too much work into it to spike off as a mixtape sometimes.
But fans just got our back.
So the fans just got our back, you know what I'm saying? And they're like, fuck this album, we count that. So we're not
count that.
But yeah, I just like, you know what I'm saying, the way we get to do the music that we want to do, and keep the designs that we want to. We get to rap and feature with some people that we grew up listening to. Shout out E40.
Oh yeah, that's right. You guys just recently did a song with E40 in Evidence. Tell me a little bit about what that was like.
Everybody's wondering why.
Tell me why this looks like a remote control of an app.
You can change the channel on the satellite.
This remote control goes to one station. That was terribly racist. So yo, E40, Evidence, we met Evidence in Switzerland, in Zurich. We had a show with Dilated Peoples at a huge festival, outdoor festival. Cool people, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, cool people. E40, we got a homeboy from Kentucky, you know what I'm saying? YB, and shout out to YB. Who actually does a lot of work with E40, and that's how we got linked up with E40. And we've been listening to E40 since Sprinkly Man. You know what I'm saying?
E40 Mill.
You're like, you know the recorder.
I had E40 Mill Man on tape. I had E40 Mill Man on tape. E40 Federal. E40 Federal.
Federal.
Mailman.
Mailman.
Hall of Major Wayne. Hall
of Game Nigger.
Wow. Now that was racist.
Was it racist?
That's something we gotta get.
I just wanna put cornrows in.
Just braid it.
It looks like a regular microphone.
Twist it up. This needs dreads by next year. I want some green feather on the dreads.
All right, well, guys, I appreciate you taking the time out. Best of luck on the rest of your tour. And hopefully we'll see you guys again. I appreciate you, homie. Thank you.
Thank you.
DJ Flip Flop.
Yeah, Flip Flop.
Spits with his hands. Yo, ask him a question.
Flip Flop. What's it like? What's it like living in front of all those people, man? You cutting it up, baby?
What Flip Flop says is actually
and he enjoys being in front of crowds and he appreciates the opportunity.
Any last words?
Shout out to Austin. All right, no doubt.
All
right, thank you. Interception.
Sorry I had to wait all night.
Hey, man.